Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you the basics of searching for files on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you want to search for files on your Mac, you may be tempted to use Spotlight, either Command Space or click here. This will bring up Spotlight Search, which gives you results for a variety of different things. But if you really just want to find a file, the best way to do it is in the Finder. So go to the Finder, and if you don't already have a window open, you can go to File, New Finder Window. Then from here, you can start to search by clicking on this box right here. You could also use Command F, but depending upon your settings, that may open up a new tab. Also, Option Command F will bring up a new Finder window and select the search box all in one shortcut. Now to start a search, all you need to do is type something here. You're going to get a variety of results. Now, what you type is going to be matched both with the name of the file, but also other things having to do with that file, like the contents of the file or the type of file. You'll get some selections here, like I can select just to search for the text I typed in the file name. It'll also show me other things like kinds or tags. So if I wanted to limit this to only results that have this word in the file name, I can select this here. And you can see now it says name, project. I could click here and switch to everything, and it will show me results that also contain that word in the contents of the file. Now also notice that you have your search area. Here it says search, and it's this Mac or documents. Why documents? Well, that's where I was when I started the search. So you can switch between searching your entire Mac, all of the hard drives connected to your Mac, or just the location you were in before. Now you can customize this in Finder Preferences, and then under Advanced, you can look here when performing a search, search the current folder, search the entire Mac, or use the previous search scope. But basically what you want to do is you want to make sure you are in the right location before you start a search. So I'm going to click the X button here to go back to my Documents folder. And let's say I know the file I want is in my Reports folder. So let's go into there first and then start the search. Now when I search for Project, I'll only get results that are in the Reports folder, but I could switch to the entire Mac if I want. Now instead of typing the name here and having to click Name Matches, and then you see it says Name Project, I could actually type it all out. I could type Name, colon, and then the text that I want to match to the name. And this will just search the names of the files, not the contents. I could click here, but I don't need to. It's already doing that search. I could do that with other things as well. For instance, I could type date today, and it will only give me results for things that have been opened, created, or modified today. I could actually just type today and then click today. Or I could type a specific date. So 3/4 will come up with the date Thursday, March 4th. I can click that and it will give me files that were either created, modified, or opened on March 4th. And the same thing with kind. I could type something that matches to a kind of file, like PDF, and you could see here I can select PDF. Or I could just type kind colon PDF and it will return files of that kind. So here I've typed the word report and it's given me a lot of results. I can add more criteria to this. I can get very specific with my search. Notice to the right here I've got a plus button. I click that plus button here, it gives me criteria and what it matches. So right now it's kind is any, but if I wanted to say kind is PDF, it would limit the search to things that have report either in the name or the contents, and kind is PDF. But I could change that to something else, like the last open date. And then I can say things like is within the last 30 days, or maybe is within the last 1 day. I can choose dates that are exactly before, after. I can use things like today, yesterday, this week, this month, or this year. For something like name, I could say name matches, but also contains, begins with, ends with, is exactly something, or is not exactly something. And I could search for content. So for instance, I know the word wombat appears in some of these. So now I can find files that have report in the name or the contents of the file, but also the contents have to contain the word wombat. And it's just these three. You could add more criteria as well. I can click the plus button here and say, well, a kind also has to be PDF. And that narrows it down to that one file. Now you can always remove some of this criteria by using the minus button. If you want to get more complex, you can hold the Option key down and notice the plus button changes to three dots. If I click that, I get a conditional here. Any, all, or none of the following. So you see kind is now indented under any. So I could do something like none and say kind is PDF. So instead of finding files that are PDFs, it's going to find files that are not PDFs. So now I'm looking for things that have report in the name or contents of the file. The contents also contain the word wombat, and the kind is not PDF because I'm using none here. Now I know I'm often asked about wildcards, and you can't really use wildcards like an asterisk in here to find something. But you can type something like, say, project space, and notice I've got project report alpha beta delta gamma. I could say project beta, and notice it will find the file that has both of those words there in the name. So in most cases you don't need wildcards. Just type what you want in here and it will find it for you. Now what can you do with this list once you've completed a search? Here I've searched for the word work, and you can see there are a bunch of results here. Well, one thing I could do is I could select a file, and I look at the bottom here and I'll see the full path to it. So if I want to know where that file is, I could see that here. I can double click on one of these folders here, like reports, and it will actually go to the reports folder. But I could also control click, right click, or two finger click on a trackpad, and then select show in closing folder, and it will take me to that folder. A shortcut for that is command R. If you want to preview the file, you can use quick look. So a quick tap of the space bar brings up quick look for the file. But you could also use view and then show preview, and it brings up the preview pane here in the search results just like you would see it in any Finder window. So I can now look through all of these different files and see a preview here on the right. And note that even though list view is the default view here, which is handy because then you could sort by kind or control click here in the header row and add things like size and then say sort by size, you can also switch the view. So you can go to icon view for your results. You can go to column view for the results. You can also go to gallery view, which is really useful if your results are mostly images. So now I have a large preview in the middle here, and I can click or use the arrow keys to go between the results of the search and find the file I want. And of course, if you want to open the file, just double click it and it will open it in its default app. Now there are a lot of cool features in Finder searches. Way too many to go into here in a tutorial that's meant to go over the basics. But I'll show you a couple of them. One is you could save a search. So here I'm searching for work in the reports folder. If I click save, it will save it as a saved search. I could place that save search anywhere I want. By default, it's going to go in my special save searches folder. But I could put it in my documents folder on the desktop, anywhere I want. And I can select add to sidebar. And when I do, this search is now here on the left. So I could be looking at my documents folder, say, and click here to instantly go to those search results. And it'll be updated, of course, to have any new files that now match this search. When you add criteria to a search like this, you could do things like kind and date and all that. But you can go to other, and there are a ton of different pieces of criteria you can add, some specific to certain types of files, like a lot of these. Like for instance, exposure mode would have to do with photos. But say you want to add something like file size, you can select it here. And if you want it to appear in the menu at all times, you can check the box here. So now I can search by file size, equals, less than, greater than, is not, and then a certain size here. And notice that file size is now going to remain in this list, so I can use it easily in the future without having to go to other. And one last tip, you can use Boolean search terms like and or to search for things. So for instance, I could search for something like project or alpha, and the key is to capitalize or. Now it's going to show me files that have project or the word alpha in either the name or contents of the file. But I could also say not, and it will show me files that have project but not the word alpha. I could also specify things like project not kind PDF, and it will show me things that match project but are not PDFs. I can even use parentheses. So I could say something like kind PDF or kind JPEG, and then say name must have work in it. And I'll get results that match that complex Boolean structure. So that's the tip of the iceberg. There's a lot more that you can do to narrow down your search. But the whole idea is to be able to find the file or files you're looking for. And that should give you the basic tools to be able to do that. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.